11 verse 12. He who is full of wisdom despises his neighbor, but a man of understanding hold his peace. When there's no wisdom in our life, we easily fall to the hand of Satan. Why? We sell everything cheap. We sell ourselves cheap. We sell our concernment cheap. We sell the glory of the Lord cheap. And that's what happened to David. In the 2 Samuel chapter 12, 2 Samuel chapter 12, this is a man that asked his own wife. He asked many glory, to the extent that he was not even in the battle because of many servants he asked, many warriors he asked. God so blessed him to the extent that talk of anything David does not have. But just because Satan want to ridicule the name of the Lord through him, and then he brought him to the top of his house. What did David see? He saw a naked body of a woman. And as a result of that, David made everything possible. He slept with a woman. After he slept with the woman, he still killed the man. Can we now say, anointed man of God? A person the Bible say, God himself say, this is a man after my heart. Can do that. And that's why we always tell everyone of us, do not brag. Do not come and proud. That I trust myself. At this level, there's nothing, this kind of thing, I can never do it. Are you spoken before devil? You didn't hide the grace of the Lord. This devil you are talking about, even before Jesus Christ was sent to the world, he has been in the world. Before you are created, this devil we are talking about, he has been created. He knows everything about what we are saying, to the extent that Bible, history was telling us that he was favorite of Almighty God. Then you are boasting. We are advising you that you don't visit a woman in the house alone. You say, no, I know him. You can never do that to me. It was in this recent message, everyone of us that listened to it, pastor was telling us, if you are using 1 hour with another man's wife, you are putting that man in problem. I realized myself. If you are using 1 hour with another man's wife as a man, you are putting that woman into problem. I realized that. I didn't know. My dear brother, my dear sister. And then somebody told me, whenever there's a woman and a man separately, and there's nobody there, the third person that is with them is devil. This was saying, run away. And we are telling you, sir, it's not possible. I cannot fall to that kind of temptation. Who are you? We are talking about somebody that's been in this world more than 1,000 years, more than 2,000 years. We are talking about devil, that he was there when the world is being created. And you are not telling me you are, if this English is correct, you are braver than him. You are deceiving yourself. And the word of the Lord, you think you have been preaching, you have been saying, you are playing with it, and hell is waiting. The same thing like this man, let's say Pastor David, Evangelist David. Everybody know as a man that somebody said, this is man after my heart. Tell me, which kind of wife he has no wife to the extent that his servant wife, David decided to sleep with. What is that reproach? If that kind of reproach can come to David, my dear brother, my dear sister, do not elude yourself from it. So if a trial come, if anything come, and you fall, but either by the word of your mouth, by your heart, or by your behavior, and people know you as a deeper lover, people know you as a Christian, people know you as a people that may carry Bible, in your place of work, they know you as a pastor. And shut a thing upon. Not only that reproach come unto you, that reproach come to the name of the Lord. And that's why we need to be careful of whatever we are doing, so that the name of the Lord or Jesus Christ will not be crucified through our life in second time. When women face this kind of problem and they do not have child, you know how it always be. Especially in the culture whereby we come from. First year, they see no dark stomach coming out. Second year, the stomach is still flat. Third year, there is no grammar of my wife has given birth to baby. Fourth year, there is no, oh, congratulations. The reproach always be too much. And that's what you can say even from our culture only, even in Jew culture. Let's look at the book of Psalm, chapter 27, verse 3. Book of Psalm, 27, verse 3. And let us see what the Bible says. 27, verse 3. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Lord, children are an heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. So by the time you marry, by the time you come together as a husband and wife, and there's no children, that means it's a reproach. That's how big. Because the Bible told us that, Lord, children are heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. No pregnancy, no child. Report comes. And this is how Bible look at it. As I told us, in Jew culture, they don't play with it. And I know my culture too, they don't play with it. But let's go to something that is biblical. And that's what happened to Rachel. In the book, let's look at Genesis chapter 30, verse 23. Genesis 30, 23. Let's look at what happened to Rachel. What he asked the child. And he said, she said, 30, 23. She said, and she conceived and bore a son. I said, God has taken away my reproach. God will take away your reproach in Jesus' name. You shall not be barren. Our desert shall turn to fruitful land in the name of Jesus Christ. And we shall be fruitful in the vineyard in the name of Jesus Christ. Another thing, Anna, as I've told us, in the first book, we have read it, in the first Samuel chapter 1, verse 7, let us see whenever one does not have children, Anna was being mocked. Why? Because it was barren. But in all areas, devil is mocking us. That see him. 20 years, it has been said, he has salvation. 15 years, it has been said, he has salvation. 10 years, 5 years, he has been telling everybody that he is in the Lord. But still, there's not a single soul that he can say he has brought to the Lord. A testimony is coming to our mouth today in Jesus' name. Let's look at the book of Isaiah and see how strong that reproach is. When we leave the church and we forget all the messages we are listening to, all the assignment God has given to us, all go ye into the world. But our go ye into the world is come me into my house. Go ye, come. Come and hear about this. Come and hear about that. Come and see what these people has done. Come and see what my husband have done for me again. Come and see how my wife have been ridiculing me. Come and see my children. They never listen. That goal is not in our mouth to go into the world. But God is changing everything from today in Jesus' name. Isaiah know important of that thing. And he said in the book of Isaiah chapter 4 verse 1. Isaiah 4 1. Let's see how that reproach is too big. When there is something in our life that is not praising the name of the Lord, that is, we cannot see the altar of the grace of the Lord in it, what Isaiah said about it. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by your name to take away our reproach. I'm 30 years old. 42 years old. 33 years old. 50 years. But there's no child. Why? Because Israelites, they have fought a lot of battle. And as a result of that, their men has gone. Many of them have died. Now, to find somebody to marry them become a problem. Then the Bible was prophesying that a time is coming. All these women has gone. All these men have gone. But the time is coming that women will be asking, please marry me so that I can have children, I can have a child, so that the reproach will be go out of my. You can see how big that reproach is. And this is that reproach we don't count as anything. We are taking with our lesser hand. As far as we eat 3 meal food, fine. That's why we can enjoy our house, fine. That's why we are feeding, fair, fine. That's why we are riding anything, fine. Any car, that's why we are doing anything. Because we go in our house, then people will say, hey, see them, they are focused. Fine. But one reproach is there. They are mocking us. There's no soul. They are won to the Lord. Won't you just thank God when the opportunity comes? Like as this woman was saying, come and marry me, just have my children. Won't you thank God that if it is that thing you are going to do for me, let me win soul unto you. So that I will not be barren spiritually. By the power and the blood of Jesus, for many of us that was crying, God will wipe away our tears on this issue in Jesus' name. We have seen what reproach is as a childless spirit, as a childless person, as a childless man, as a childless woman in the Bible, in our spiritual life, we know, we can see now that we need to wake up so that we can bring people into the house of the Lord. We may be thinking that it is only woman. Bible was making as an example, women. God knows how important children are to us too. Let's look at the book of Psalm, 128. And see what the Bible said. For you shall eat the labor of your hand. Happy shall you be, and it shall be well with you. Your wife shall be as fruitful vine by the side of your house. Your children like olive plant round about your table. Simple as ABC. Your wife shall, I won't say anything negative, but what the Bible is saying is this. We men, if our wife does not have children, that means we are not fruitful. So the same way God speaks to women, the same way he speaks to us men, that bearing children is very, very important. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, spiritually, we start bearing children in Jesus' name. Let us now come to the interpretation of it together. In the book of Romans, chapter 7, verse 4. The book of Romans, chapter 7, verse 4. Book of Rome, I mean, letter of Paul to Romans. Chapter 7, verse 4. And let us see what the Bible says. Wherefore, my brethren, you also are become dead to the law. Letter of Romans, chapter 7, verse 4. Wherefore, my brethren, you are also becoming dead to the law by the body of Christ. That you should be married to another, even to him who is raised from the dead. So, my dear brother, my dear sister, immediately we become born again Christian. Immediately we become a new creature. Immediately we accept Jesus Christ as our Savior. We are married to that Christ. And every one of us know the church is the wife, Christ is the husband spiritually. Then why are we not barren? Why are we not having children for him? And we have seen the reproach on Anna, we have seen the reproach on Rebecca, we have seen the reproach on man when they have no children. And the Bible is telling us here in that Romans chapter 4, wherefore my brethren, you also have become dead to the law by the body of Christ, that you should be married to another, even to him who is raised from the dead, that we should bring forth fruit unto the Lord. But where's your fruit? Where's my fruit? Why are you not bothering when you get home and be thinking, as I do this, as I do that, I need to be bothered about having soul to the kingdom of God, what are we folding our hands? What is it not anything before all? What are we not counting it as a something that is very important? What are we not saying it the way we are saying we lack this, we lack that? What are we not presenting it to the Lord the way we are presenting our, I mean, what is it bothering us in our heart? What are we not so bothering, I mean, bother about all those things that are so significant to the Lord, but we bother about what is significant to the body, so that people can praise us, so that people can say we are there, so that people can say we have arrived. Have you forgotten? The Bible said they are not part of the world, but they are in the world. So your thought, your aim, your dream, your ambition, your goal will be different from the people of the world. Jesus knew important of this when he was going. He said, God, he knows what you can do. He knows you very well. Have you forgotten what the Bible said? He said, from your womb, I know you. He knows that if you are going to be careless about his work, he knows you are not going to be bothered. He knows you are going to be running after the second thing. And then give you, I mean, seeking first the kingdom of God. You know what you are going to be seeking for is the second one that is supposed to be added. He knows. And then he has a sample of you in the disciple. You know, there's no kind of character you can have that is not in the disciple he has. He not told God, God, I know them. From their womb, I know them. But please, please, Almighty God, they are not part of the world. Keep them. God will keep you in Jesus' name. God will keep me in Jesus' name. But when God is praying for you, you need to realize that he loves you. And you need to surrender your thoughts. You need to surrender everything unto him. In the book of Isaiah, chapter 5. Isaiah chapter 5, 1 to 2. By the power and the blood of Jesus, our fires, our life shall bring fruit into the house of the Lord in Jesus' name. We shall not do it in vain. All what I'm telling you is this. The way you are handling your life, the way you are handling something that is important in your life, the way I'm handling my children, I don't want them to be stumbled. The way I'm handling my life, I want to be fruitful. The way I'm handling my wife, so that I can be proud of having a wife in the house. The way I'm handling my husband, so that people can know that I have a good husband. The way I'm handling my parents, so that they can know they have a son. The way I'm handling my academy, so that I can perform excellently. The way I'm handling my work so that my boss cannot fire me and do the work of God. As simple as ABC. Hardly, many of us, we are thinking about God for 30 minutes in a day. 30 minutes in a day, hardly. Because by the time we wake up, my wife, my husband, my children, let us pray. Pam. 25 minutes, 10 minutes, that one has gone. We go to work, we do everything. We read this one, we do that, we did that, we did that. How will our fire be fruitful? And then many of us, we think that God is so bland. We are sick. Do you know? Have you forgotten what he said unto them after he provided food for them? Then the one in the second day, he said, "You are not looking for me because of the kingdom of God. You are looking for me because of what I provided for you yesterday." Many of us, we are searching that Lord because of what we want to receive, not because we love him. The question is, my message is, are you searching your mind? Can people be sincerely tell you that it is not because you are in problem, it is not because in this situation, it's not because you love God? Can people see that character in you? That no matter what the situation may be, God first. Can people have testimony about your life that I know him? He loves Almighty God. God will help us in Jesus' name. But there's a solution. And this is your joy. This is my joy. You know, that's why I love him. He loves us so much. And he's so good to us. To the extent that whenever we put ourselves into problem for not listening to him, he still bail us out. But we are going to yield to destruction in Jesus' name. In the first book, in the first Samuel chapter 17, verse 26. First Samuel 17, 26. And David spoke to the men who stood by him, saying, "What shall be done to the man who killed this Philistine and take away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should divide the army of the living God?" David, when the Goliath was proud, making noise. The same thing. The sea is approaching. The sea is shaking us. Negligence is killing us. Our will is taking us away. And our ambition is slowing us down from the work of the Lord. But today, I know you are hearing the word of the Lord. And you will take that five throne David took to conquer devil in Jesus' name. And victory is yours. Do not let anything weigh you down. You know, it's like I should share this testimony, but something is telling me that I should hold on. See, everything comes to an end. But God is so wonderful. The richness, empowerment, whatever you are looking onto, is in his hand without you being stressful at all. Just wait. The Bible say that may be written on the wall, but it's just a matter of time. It may be tarry, but it will come to pass. My dear brother, my dear sister in the Lord, you know that sister that came the last time, she said something that is very wonderful unto me. After staying for 2 weeks, and then we give her a side scripture. He said, if nothing has been given to him, he said, this side of scripture is enough for him. I was touched. The site description is $10. But she said, I don't know if anyone was listening to him. He said, if nothing is being given to her, he said, this side scripture is enough for me. Have you forgotten the golden treasure that that man saw and he sold everything in order to buy this golden treasure? Then what is too big in our heart? What is so big in our eyes? What is so big in our environment? What is so big in our heart that we don't want it to let it go to accommodate Almighty God? Let us solve this mind. He is wonderful. He can do it. And he is going to do it. Let it go. Try him. And his glory is going to be upon every one of us in Jesus' name. At the long run, David conquered Goliath. You are going to conquer in Jesus' name. All things, all the trespasses, all the agent of devil, all things that's causing limitation in our spiritual life that do not let us be fruitful, from today we are becoming a victor upon them in Jesus' name. Do not forget, you are the army of living God in your family, in your environment, in any area you are. And if you are like somebody like me, God has brought us so far up to this level. And you know, and he has not stopped working. And he will not stop working. We will get to the destination in Jesus' name. The little way we surrender to the Lord, the little way we are walking with him, that's the little way we are seeing the reward. No wonder the Bible says, wake up from your slumber. Wake up from your spiritual doze. Wake up from your negligence. Who come to the word of the Lord? Who come to Almighty God and see what is going to do? He that starts it will finish it in Jesus' name. And that Abraham blessing shall be yours in Jesus' name. Another person that faced that reproach, that won the battle, is Nehemiah. How can you imagine a country came and took the Israelite, the Jew, and took them to Israel? To the extent that they are now asking them, sing the song in the land of the strange land. But when the Nehemiah heard the word of the Lord, when he heard the report of Jerusalem, his mind was wounded. My dear brother, my dear sister in the Lord, if you let your mind be wounded today, that since we are in Charlottesville, although we are thanking God, we are praising the name of the Lord. I was telling my brother that I was telling him that one thing I know I'll be deeper life in Charlottesville is this. We may not be many. All of us we might have been wounded on the battlefield, but we are not compromising and we have never decided to go back. And we are not going to go back in Jesus' name. And I was telling you, there's nobody I know that joined this Deeper Life Bible Church. It's either he lives or accept the word of the Lord. It's either of the two. But no compromising. And we are not going to compromise in Jesus' name. Nehemiah found himself in the land of the stranger. He did not compromise. Instead, he asked that, let me go back. so that we can build the Jerusalem. He will build the Jerusalem in Jesus' name. Have you forgotten what the Bible say? Those who love the Jerusalem, they shall prosper. This is your own Jerusalem. Deeper Life Charlottesville is your own Jerusalem. I'm telling you, the little I walk with him, I'm seeing the impact in my life. This week is another miracle. And he will do it. And I was saying, he has not stopped. I've not discussed this one with my arrow. Whenever I call my arrow and discuss with him that this is what God has done, this is what God has done, arrow always tell me he has just started. And then whenever he's praying for my family, I only take note of one sentence he always say. That's why the I and him, we don't see eye to eye. He always say, I thank God for this family because they love God. We went through a lot, all of you know. Oh, my lecturer took me out recently. Yeah, I think that was on Friday. He just saw me and said, Matthew, I want to take you. I said, well, I was wondering why. But when I was sharing the testimony of our life, everything is by the grace of the Lord. And if not that by the grace, all of us will not be together today. But let that grace manifested more. Bear fruit. Nehemiah bear fruit. And he went back. He built Jerusalem. We are going to build Jerusalem of Charlotte in Jesus' name. It's not going to use any other person. It's going to use only you. And I can see that no one among us say amen. That's what the pastor was saying. That I went to CAC. I preach about money. All of them, they offload their pockets. I went to Assembly of God. I prayed about. But when I come to Deeper Life, natural amen. But things is changing by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. Why are we suffering? Why are we not being? We are not productive. It's not because of any other thing. It is because of our hypocrisy. One leg in, one leg out. Saying one thing, do one thing. Half full something, give half to the Lord. Say, I surrender all on the people. We know how to lie. Be on watch here singing, I surrender all to Jesus. But our time, our money, all other things we have, is not surrender. Then tell me how you want to be productive. It's not possible. It's not possible. You can't give half of a thing. He knows you. He knows you more than I know you. And he knows that you are. He was the one that said a liar. And we are singing, we are praying, and we are even lying. To somebody that said this, anybody that lied, this is what is going to call. This is what will be the result. That's why we are not succeeding, we are not conquering. But from today, God is changing our testimony in Jesus' name. And by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, we will continue to see ourselves the way God wants us to be in Jesus' name. In the book of Isaiah 61, verse 3. Isaiah 61, verse 3. Isaiah. Unto them, woman in Zion, to give unto them beauty of ashes, the oil of joy of mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that it might be glorified. It will be glorified in your life, it will be glorified in my life in Jesus' name. From this morning, from this particular time, the pregnancy, the womb of Holy Spirit, God will give to every one of us in Jesus' name. That as we are living here, we will be thinking of the message, we will be thinking of how to be productive to Almighty God in Jesus' name. The only thing that will not be forgotten is the impact we have in the life of others. And then, my dear brother, my dear sister in the Lord, we have separated ourselves from the people of the world. Soccer, we are not playing. So that we can become number 7, maybe Maradona, that they will be remembering his name. Dancing, we are not doing. So that we can become that pop singer that everybody still remember his name till now. Basketball, we are not there. So that the richest man in the world they know that play basketball, they can remember us for that. Boxing, we are not doing it. It's even against the will of the Lord. That's what we say, because we need to exercise. God demanded. But the one we are doing, there is no impact of it in our life. That's the reason why we will rise up this morning and call upon the name of the Lord. Father, let me be productive. Let us rise up, call upon the name of the Lord. Feed me with your Holy Spirit. Sessional leader, you have no excuse. God has brought many people onto your hand. If they miss the kingdom of God, this is a great opportunity. Pastor Matthew, you have no excuse. All these people we are here together, they must get to the kingdom of God. If not by force, by prayer, they must get there by kneeling down. All our prayer leaders, you have no excuse. Those people who are singing, you have no excuse. Call upon the name of the Lord, that you will be fruitful. Call upon him. Look at all those souls in your hand. Are they going to be destroyed in hell? Look at your children. Look at your spouse. Look at your family. Look at the church of the Lord. Call upon the name of the Lord. Father, it's a reproach. When you are barren spiritually, it's a reproach. It is because we are in spiritual realm. We do not know that it's a reproach. Call upon the name of the Lord. Father, wipe away my tears. Let me be fruitful. Year 2016 has gone. This 2017, what accounts are you going to give to the Lord? You say, yes, you speak to them, I speak to them, they are not winning soul. Is it the same way you are pursuing your other thing? You are pursuing those souls? Let us be sincere. Let us be sincere. Is it the same way you are pursuing the other thing? You are pursuing those souls? But we said, yeah, yes, we have done a lot, including me. I visited them. They are not in church. I visit them and they do not come. You see, the same way I'm pursuing mathematics, I'm pursuing the soul. Then call upon the name of God. Use me. God, use me. Imagine, just through you, 10 people are born again and we are seeing them. But if I say, imagine, you have 10 houses, you will see us smiling. Happy, say hey, hallelujah. But when it comes to the soul, you take it with a lesser hand because it doesn't matter. Call upon the name of the Lord. Father, let me be fruitful. Let me be fruitful. That your friends, that your family member, they must not go to hell. The church in Tel Aviv must be built. As a Jerusalem of winning soul, you must be able to tell God that God, I brought this into you. I brought this into you. We have seen the film of hell. Call upon him.
Henceforth, you will not be barren in your spiritual life. Your Christian life will not be a life of barrenness. That you will not be like the fig tree that produces no fruit. That you will not be a wastage of divine resources God have invested in you. He's expecting return for his kingdom. That all that invested in you, that it will be productive, it will be profitable to the kingdom of God. That even after you've gone, that the impact other people, young believers, they will be motivated, they will be inspired by it, by the footsteps that you've laid down. The work of the Great Commission, and you will take it with utmost priority. In Jesus' name we've prayed. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word, O God, that has come forth. Father, you said we should go into the world and multiply. Lord, we know, O God, that a harvest is ripe. And that is why you have sent us for that we should harvest them, O God, and bring them into your kingdom. Father, we ask that from today that we will go in that might and harvest souls for you in Jesus' name. That we will be harvesters of souls. That the grace, O God, that saved us, that called us out of darkness and imputes us. Father, we ask that that grace, O God, will not be in vain. That if we have experienced that grace, that we will take it forth and bring more people into your kingdom. Father, we don't want to go to heaven alone. For you said, O God, in your Father's heart, there are many mansions. Father, if we don't win so, then who will occupy those mansions? Father, today, give us the wisdom. You say, he that winneth soul is wise. Help us to be wise, oh God, that we will win souls to your kingdom in Jesus' name. Father, we pray that you will give us the strategy. That you will give us, oh God, everything that we need, oh God. That we will not be short of ideas. That we will not be short of strategy, oh God. When it comes to winning souls, oh God, we will not be like babies. That when it comes to winning souls, oh God, that we will not be foolish. That when it comes to winning souls, oh God, that we will not be complacent and not challenged. But rather, oh Lord, that we will be fervent. That we will be passionate, oh God. Father, anoint every one of us. That as we go out, oh God, to speak your word, that every word, oh God, will be confirmed, oh God, with power. That souls will be transformed. In Jesus' name we've prayed. Let's share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Text somebody, be wise and win soul.